sticking with us here on CI Living on WCIA 3. Take a look at that. That's just a little taste of Italy in the CI kitchen today, or it will be as soon as our guest chef is done with
it. That's right. And joining us for What's for Dinner is our guest chef, Jim Nelson from Riantuo. Welcome to CI Living.
Thank you.
All right. So tell us a little bit about your inspiration for dinner tonight.
Well, my inspiration came from our 30th anniversary trip when we took to Italy in May. And during that time, we went to Tuscany, stayed in a 750 AD castle.
That's what
Wow.
Nice.
And while
Tornano.
Right. And while we were in that castle, I had an opportunity to have a lesson with the chef from Italy there and learned about cooking in Italy. Primarily, an Italian meal starts with about four different courses that are served. The second course is usually a pasta, and one of the pastas I learned to make was gnocchi pasta or potato pasta. So it starts with potatoes and flour, and you actually rice the cooked potatoes. You cook them with the skins on.
Those are potatoes. They look like pineapple.
Yeah.
It's definitely potatoes.
Okay.
That's a fancy contraption, too.
This is a ricer. And basically what you do is you rice the potatoes into the flour. Then you're going to knead the flour and the potatoes together with the heel of your hand until it becomes a lump of dough, like this.
Okay.
Then,
and you can see bits of potato in this.
Right, right.
And that's okay.
That's okay.
Okay.
And then what happens is you end up rolling it out. And I've rolled out a little piece here. But you cut it, roll it, and on this board. And then when you get it rolled out, you start cutting the pieces like this. And that's the gnocchi. And then I'm going to drop a couple pieces in there. They take about 2 minutes to cook. And then when they sink when they first go into the pot, but when they come to the top, then they're done.
Smart. They tell you themselves that they're ready.
Yes, mm-hmm. It's important to get them out right as soon as they come to the top.
Al dente. Yes, that's correct. So this is the basic process for making gnocchi pasta.
How long does it usually take before they come to the top?
Two minutes.
And I see that you've got the flour. Do you coat them in flour before you stick them in the water?
You just coat them in flour so they don't stick together.
Got it. Yeah. Okay.
And then as soon as they're done, you're going to want to put them into some kind of sauce because the gnocchi pasta is potato pasta. It has flavor of potato, but you're going to want to use whatever kind of sauce that best fits your taste. In my case, I'm going to make a sauce that they told me to make, which was olive oil, garlic, red pepper, Roma tomatoes chopped up, and then the pasta followed up with arugula.
And you took this as a lesson. Are you now giving lessons here?
Well, you know, the idea is to share what you have, and I enjoy cooking for my friends and being able to tweak things for my friends in a way that the food fits with whatever's best for them.
Yeah, so what would go great with this dish?
Well, the first course that I learned to make was zucchini pudding with gorgonzola cream sauce. Then it was followed by a meat. Meats in Italy don't always excite me as much. It was ham with mint. And then the final course that I made was tiramisu.
Ooh, yum.
So, wow.
So that's a typical meal, and it usually starts out with some kind of pasta. And then I also brought you, or I'm sharing with you, some biscotti that I learned to make in Italy, and they're covered with like chocolate. So.
Whoa. So, can't wait to check that out. Okay, it looks like it's finally floating up.
It is. It is. Heather, and you, well.
Oh, yeah, go for it.
You're and this is what a pasta looks like when it's done then. And I'm simply, you fish them out of there when they float. And that's all there is to it.
And then how long do they need to cook in the skillet here?
Not long. The pasta is already done. So what's going to happen, I don't have anything in the skillet, the rest of the ingredients. I'm going to do that in a little bit. But basically what's going to happen, I'm going to start adding the chopped up garlic and make the sauce.
All right. Well, we're going to let you work.
All right.
So glad that you're here.
I feel so chef-like.
Yeah. And you actually toss the pasta when you get it. So if you feel like tossing something, that's... Yeah, well, easy.
Yeah, easy, Matt. Oh, my goodness.
Fair enough.
Okay, you stick around. We actually have this recipe on CILiving.tv right now if you're interested in making it for dinner tonight. Coming up ahead, we are helping save for your child's college education, including me, BC Bank, is here with a short quiz. I hope I pass. We're going to see if we know the answers, and we're going to learn ways to improve our own college savings.
Mom, look at it this way. Since you got two young ones, even if you don't, they're going to be that much better prepared.
That's right.
Yeah. Plus, we're searching for...